Explosive new details emerging about the man who was known as the Cookie Bandit. Good evening. I'm Doug Fernandez.
I'm Shelley Ribando. He shot and killed a Sandoval County deputy last week, and now we have learned the bandit's real name is Joseph Henry Burgess. He was an internationally wanted killer and even had his picture posted on Interpol's website. Burgess shot and killed Sandoval County Sergeant Joe Harris early Thursday morning.
Right now, we have a team of reporters in the field covering all the latest developments. We begin with Alana Gold in Santa Fe with more on Burgess's criminal past.
Doug, today we learned Joseph Burgess wasn't just a burglar here in New Mexico. He was linked to a double homicide in Canada back in 1972, and he's been wanted ever since. We talked to the lead investigator for that case, and he says he retired knowing this man wouldn't be caught. New Mexico State Police now know the man who terrorized homes in the Jemez Mountains for nearly a decade is 62-year-old Joseph Henry Burgess, a fugitive wanted for shooting a couple to death inside their tent at a British Columbia campsite back in 1972.
There was nothing to indicate that he was in any way remorseful after the murder.
Dan Creeley was the lead investigator on that case. He says Burgess was part of a group called the Children of God and thinks his religious beliefs were the reason behind the killings.
He caught them in the act of maybe making love, and according to the Book of Job, that was fornication. He did not believe in that.
Creeley says they linked Burgess to the crime after finding his belongings about a mile away from the scene.
We found his eyeglasses, we found his personal papers, found his We found almost everything but his rifle and his body.
This retired investigator believes Burgess was hiding out, possibly in the United States, but he can't believe it took authorities nearly 40 years to catch him and that Burgess was shot and killed in this New Mexico cabin.
It's amazing that he was allowed to avoid detection for so long because, you know, we had his fingerprints on record in Ottawa.
After the murders in Canada, Burgess tore up the victims' IDs, and that's how investigators got his fingerprints. But when he died last week, local authorities didn't know who he was, so they took his fingerprints, checked with the FBI, and made a match. Reporting live, Alana Gold, KOAT Action 7 News.